This is the most gorgeous looking game I've ever wanted to slap in the face. This is pretty much David Cage's way of saying, hey gamers, let me distract you from this convoluted story I'm about to tell with these magnificent outfits. Isn't that the same douchebag Paco Mendez from Heavy Rain? Discount Barney Calhoun. Tutorial. And this is after I chose the option, I play video games often. Isn't that basically the same contraption that the Riddler used in Batman Forever? Sloppy item controls. And you know, I actually would have been impressed by this item mechanic if Ghost Trick didn't do it already. Lady in red. Fake Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah, I'm gonna shake some hands, blend in, find some more quiet. You know what you have to do.
Yeah, but we don't. Because your narrative is broken. Bloody orgasms. What the hell is this guy knocking on the women's bathroom for? Discount Farah. Also, she must be unimportant because she'll never be seen in the game again. Ah, so this is what Ellie might have looked like if the world hadn't gone to hell.
Don't worry. It's gonna be alright.
It's gonna be okay when it's really not cliche. Housewife of Beverly Hills.
Oh, is it a present for me? Cool, thanks.
Unit 4? The paranormal department.
Ooh, what you do there? Bend spoons or speak to dead people?
No.
Stuff like that?
Man, Ash Ketchum is such a dick. No option to turn on some Daft Punk or Gorillaz at this lame-ass party. Scene does not contain any Ellen Page twerking.
I used to live in London before I moved here 2 years ago. I surf any chance I get and I play in a band with a bunch of friends.
Well, you're not the most cliche fruitcake ever.
It's a really rare collection. Poems by Edgar Allan Poe.
Edgar Allan who?
Bitch doesn't know who Edgar Allan Poe is. This sequence does not contain enough Carrie-like brutality. Choppy and inconsistent narrative, and this is a problem that will persist throughout the entire game, which means it's worth about 40 sins. Unless you're Quentin Tarantino, you should not be doing this. Dialogue options suggest that the conversation will differ with each choice, but they never do. You will get the same outcome every time. Yet another problem that will persist throughout the entire game. 30 sins it is. PlayStation 3 game feels more like a Kinect game. The overuse of this slow action mechanic, and it will persist throughout the entire game, which means it's worth about 30 sins. Discount Sonya Blade or Jill Valentine. Whichever you prefer, it's still a sin. Wow! Now this is some pretentious bullshit. Now why is the train going nuts like this? We're not on an airplane experiencing turbulence. This was clearly added for dramatic effect and failed miserably because it doesn't make any sense. Where the hell did this cop come from? It's almost as if David Cage was like,
you know what, guys? I want to put a battle on top of a train, and I don't care how you segue into it or if it makes sense for the story. Just put it in there.
These guys are terrible shots. Animal abuse.
See anything?
Nothing but rock.
Are you f***ing kidding me? They don't spot her up there? There are absolutely zero consequences when failing any portion of the game, which basically means you can't die. At all. Kind of ruins the fun, the thrill, and the point of playing the game. Whether it's lazy game design or David Cage not giving a shit is irrelevant. It's still a sin. Discount Tess. Who wears sandals during sub-freezing weather? Cassette player? Barbie dolls. Does David Cage not know the difference between cooking oil and motor oil?
Great, now I can be bored and freezing.
Oh, well you look at that. Jody just perfectly described how I'm feeling while playing this game.
Did you see that? She nearly killed me! You saw what she did
Jody.
To me? She's a witch! A dirty, rotten witch!
Now why would the kid think that Jody was the one choking him? It makes no sense whatsoever, and it makes even less sense that any of the other kids or adults would believe him. It just looks like he was having breathing problems. This game is trying way too hard to make Jody into a victim of Aiden's powers.
I'm sick and tired of your stories! Jody, this time you're really gonna get it!
And now!
Well, someone needs to lay off the alcohol.
Susan, that's no little girl. Susan, that's a monster.
Philip makes foster parents look bad. Oh my god, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you all the most hype gameplay on the internet! Oh, never mind.
The DPA has launched a program to study the other side, the infraquote as they call it. They've created a condenser, machines to open a rift to what lies beyond.
Now, this is the point of the game where I almost stopped playing. I was fine with the whole ghost protecting Ellen Page shenanigans, but now we're going to involve these entities from another dimension and unlocking this pseudo Stargate Doom portal to the Infraworld BS? Really?
Jody, if you don't want to do it, just say, and I'll take you back.
Now, why would you offer to turn back when literally not 30 seconds ago you said,
only you know how to deal with what lies beyond the rift.
Don't worry. I don't plan on dying today.
I don't plan on dying, cliche. Well, this isn't a ripoff of Metal Gear Solid 2. Hipster jeans. Fire does not stay stationary like this. It spreads, then you burn, and then you die.
Powerful concentration of energy.
Really? This guy was given a presentation while the facility was engulfed in flames? Did this guy seriously just douse himself out? Oh yeah, damn near killed by possessed Slender Man, but sure. I'm just gonna walk away like nothing happened. Video game cliche number 19. The guy with the keys is always the one in the back sitting all by himself. Wait, is this Black Mesa? Hey look, it's the blue eye of Sauron! See what happens when you open up the Infraworld's vagina? You release all these Venom symbiote, ing, Matrix Sentinel STDs into the real world and we're all f***ed. Really? She just saved all your asses from certain death and not a single round of applause? David Cage pretty much reuses this same scene from Indigo Prophecy. What kind of store is only open for 2 hours? Payphones still exist?
My name's Stan.
Supporting character named Stan dresses like Stan from South Park. Gee, Stan, you live surprisingly well for a homeless man. Game somehow manages to make Ellen Page look ugly. Discount John Mayer. It goes from daytime to nighttime in a matter of seconds. This is cool and all, but wasn't Jody basically starving and damn near death just a few minutes ago? Where'd she find all the energy to take all these guys down? You're not a true douchebag unless you're like this guy and film your friends getting their asses kicked by a 5-foot woman and posting it on the internet.
How did you do that?
I learned how to fight in the army.
You didn't train in the army. You trained in the CIA.
All right, Jimmy. Down the road always is this old abandoned building. Figure out a way inside.
Now wait just a damn minute. If Stan and the others already knew about this abandoned building before, then why did they just relocate there instead of staying out in the cold under a bridge? And who the f*** is wasting their time paying the electric bill for this abandoned building?
I can see it! I can see the head! I can see the head just push! Push! Oh, you did it, Tuesday.
Wow, that was like the easiest birth ever.
Help me!
Come on, Jimmy! Jump! Jump!
No! No, I can't make it!
How are you gonna scream for help and then refuse help? Grow a f***ing backbone, chump!
Bring it back! I changed my mind! I want that baby!
So get here quickly!
Now why were you giving up your baby in the first place? There are three things wrong with this hospital scene. First, there are no wires for breath rate, heart rate, or pulse. Next, if there's gonna be anything attached to the body going into a machine and it's pulled out, a nurse is gonna go to your room and check on you. And lastly, an IV is never gonna be that easy to pull out. Game somehow manages to make Ellen Page look ugly again.
She's been in a coma for several months.
Can we see her?
No. Are you family?
We're with the CIA. This girl is wanted for treason.
Why did it take the CIA several months before they started searching for Jody? She was wanted for treason, right? Okay. Wouldn't it have made sense to keep constant tabs on her? Maybe cuff her hands and feet so she wouldn't be able to easily escape like she did here? Hey look, it's Namin Jaden from Heavy Rain! And he's bald, and he's ugly as f***. Being able to walk around and jump out of a window after being in a coma for several months is a failure of game design. Ghost powers or not. Who puts the stove right next to the sink?
My God, Jody!
Now where were these assholes when Jody was being attacked? They have the cameras. Ellen Page goes emo.
It's just not fair! How come everyone can go and I can't? I didn't ask to be different. I just want to go out and have friends and be like other girls my age.
Really? In the previous party chapter, Jody displays that she is shy and reserved and show that the only real people she was in contact with were these assholes who picked her up and locked her in the closet. And she almost burned those f***ers to the ground. That being said, who are these supposed friends that she's seemingly desperate to hang out with? And why does she even want to be social? I mean, you could give the excuse that she's a teenager and the fact that she's been locked in this prison all these years, but still. Why would you even want to hang out with girls your age when your first experience almost led to a mass cremation?
Go ahead, I'll pretend I never saw you.
What's up, Cole? Cat got your tongue?
He lost his voice. I think it's like a virus or something. That's more than I've gotten out of him all day long, so.
Well, it's not contagious, buddy.
This guy is a horror movie guard. Discount John Goodman. Not being able to play an arcade game inside of a video game is a failure of the game design. Oh look, another pointless rape scene. It's nice to travel to the ranch where Tuco got shot. We go from daytime to nighttime in a matter of seconds. Again. So, are we actually playing Farmville now? This isn't a sin, but I am feeling the need to go to confession. What the hell is this shit? Glad to see this turn into Red Dead Redemption. Where did this radio come from? They're on a ranch in the middle of the desert. It's not like they have electricity to charge batteries. Maybe I'm being a dumbass for asking this, but let me get this straight. We're clearly in Native American territory, and we're dealing with mystic Native American spirits. So why the hell are these spirits giving Jody warning signs written in English? How and why did this turn into an episode of Ghost Hunters? Which unfortunately is not as cool as it sounds. Oh great! Yetso has returned, despite it being in the middle of the day.
Come on! Start already, goddammit!
Vehicle doesn't start up when preparing to evade evil cliche. So I guess the passage can be opened by any old gibberish uttered. This ritual is sexist. Only the women get knocked out cold.
CinemaSins!
Hey Jay, I know that you were kind of a dick, but let's just go ahead and kiss you just for the sake of pleasing David Cage's twisted fantasy of seeing this forced relationship. Oh crap, Ellie grew her hair out?
Jesus, listen up, Miss Holmes. I don't give a shit about your pathetic adolescent pouting, alright? You can rant and rave all you want, but you'll shut your mouth and do as you're told.
You do realize she has ghost powers, right? That's kind of the whole reason why you want her to join the CIA. So, not really a wise move to provoke her. Speaking of which, there's no option to use Aiden to choke Ryan to death right here and now and completely skip the whole CIA fiasco altogether. David Cage attempts to use crying as a tool to add emotional depth, but instead it comes off as straight up annoying. This is a failure of game design.
I'll come and see you as soon as I can. I'll never let you down.
But you kinda have by letting her go.
I was just wondering if you got my email.
What email?
The one I sent 3 days ago.
You know, I've actually been having problems with my computer. What was the email about?
Dinner, tonight, fancy restaurant.
So I'm guessing you guys have never heard of cell phones? You know, text messages?
Fuck this! We're not gonna start this again! I'm not yours, Aiden! I can have a relationship with whoever I want. This is my life. Okay, do you fucking hear me? This is my life. You know what? I happen to think Ryan is great. He's charming, he's intelligent, he's funny. And I think I'm falling for him.
Yeah, remember that one time when I told him to fuck off, like, 2 minutes ago? Man, I pity the fool who had to pay $60 to play this game only to find out that they gotta clean the house. Gee, haven't played through this sort of sequence either.
Lady in red.
Apartment door that doesn't have a peephole.
Are you married or anything?
No. Yes, I mean, I was. You know, my ex-wife and I have been separated for 2 years.
If she's your ex-wife, then you're divorced. Not separated. And just like that, they have the hots for each other. Game unnecessarily stops makeout session.
My wife. Lord, they were coming back from my mother's. Truck. Wrong driver. Wrong side of the road.
The most cliche excuse for an accident. This entire chapter rips off the beginning of Metal Gear Solid 4.
أنت ساحرة. كيف يمكنك فعل ذلك؟
Sorry, I don't understand a word you're saying.
And neither do we, because the game doesn't put on the damn subtitles. We went from nighttime to daytime in just a split second. This is the third random scenery change in the game. Seriously? This dude is the only one armed with a gun?
لا نتركوكي. يمكنني البقاء ولا جانبوكي. هستطيع مساعدتوكي.
Still no subtitles. The f*** is Kanye West doing in this game? Camo camera?
He's your father?
Jody is a bitch to children. Oh, we're totally turning into Resident Evil 5 here. Wow, really? They should just call this Beyond Too Many Conveniences. What? You mean to tell me that this whole mob of people couldn't break down that weak door earlier? What the hell are you guys waiting for? Kill this bitch! Nope, you can't, because the plot doesn't demand it. Just like America to invade another country and kill all of its inhabitants.
You have to find Jamal and eliminate him.
Hopes were high that the newly recognized President Jamal Sharif would be able to put an end to the hostilities that have ravaged his country for many years.
You lied to me.
What are you talking about?
Jamal wasn't a warlord. He was the president. He was the democratically elected president.
Your point? We're not politicians. We had our orders.
You knew I wouldn't have murdered him. So you lied to me.
Welcome to the CIA, Jody. It's not fucking choir practice in case you haven't noticed. Now, we had a job to do, and we did it. End of story.
The real disappointment here is not having the option to throw Ryan out the window after spouting all that treacherous nonsense.
Have they made any progress on the infraworld?
Oh, they've sunk millions into developing a new condenser. The most powerful ever created.
Oh yeah, let's build an even bigger condenser, because the last one was such a monumental success that murdered hundreds of people and almost unleashed spirit monsters that could wipe out all of humanity.
I've got to go see her.
Jody, I know how you feel, but she's in a mental hospital. You might not get the answers you're looking for.
I'm not looking for answers. I just need to see her.
Which means you want answers.
My mother's been in a mental hospital for 24 years. I mean, why? What happened?
She's in a high-security DPA facility, and you're wanted by every law enforcement agency in the country.
All right, if you know that she's wanted, then why did you agree to meet up with her in the middle of the park that's literally wide out in the open? And you're the only two out there. See, we could have had this entire conversation in the car, instead of having it in the park. Inability to distract this guard by putting porn on this computer.
Jody, she may have lost her mind.
No shit, Sherlock. She's in a mental institution. So Jody's mom is basically Sarah Connor, minus all the coolness. Predictable ambush is predictable.
Sorry, Jody. I've lost weight.
I know that sounded like a compliment, but yeah. Don't ever talk about a woman's weight. They tend to get very insecure about that.
We know another country has discovered the infraworld. They think it's something to be controlled or manipulated. They have no idea what they're dealing with.
And we do?
According to our intel, the Republic of Kazakhstan has discovered the existence of the infraworld. Found a rift, conducting experiments from a secret base located in the province of Heilongjiang.
If you know about the base, then it's not a secret.
It's good to see you.
Oh, you again. Flash forwarding to a scene in the game for you to see that you failed the mission is a failure of game design. These idiots leave their ski gear out in the cold.
What are we doing here? It's just a goddamn fishing village.
Our informer duped us. That's what happened. We better get moving before they have to dig our frozen dead asses out of here.
3 days, walking on ice, eating snow, for nothing. Fuck! I find the asshole that sent us here.
You know, for a group of trained and supposedly disciplined CIA agents, you guys whine like a bunch of little babies. Game defies characteristics of the main protagonist by having Aiden travel a lot further than he can or should. Remember how Jody is supposed to get nosebleeds if Aiden travels too far away?
It hurts like hell when you're too far away.
Yeah, that's another failure of the game design. Man, if only we had a run button.
Nick?
Sorry.
Nick is a dick.
Keep diving. The base shouldn't be far.
Let me ask you something, Jody. Are you not entitled to the sweat of your brow?
I'm going to ask the same questions over and over again until you answer them. What is your name? What do I have to do to make you speak?
Well, this guy obviously didn't go to the Revolver Ocelot School of Torture and Manipulation.
All you have to do is answer, and your comrade will not suffer anymore.
So, what are you waiting for? I don't give a damn about that guy. Go ahead. Kill him. He's an asshole.
Now what?
We find the condenser, destroy it, and get out.
And any idea how you plan to do that?
No.
How do you fools embark on the most important mission of your careers and not have a plan? Are you kidding me with this ghost condom nonsense? Hasn't the game already proven that if Aiden is a certain amount of distance away from Jody, that she starts bleeding? So wouldn't completely separating from her, like, kill her? Oh wait, is that the script flying away again? Beyond Two Souls into Darkness or Dead Space into Darkness? Whatever the hell it wants to be, it's still a sin. This ghost anglerfish could have easily killed Jody here, but since this broken plot demands it, she will survive.
Greatest discovery the world has ever known. Destroyed because of you, stupid American bitch! Years of work! All for nothing!
The very fact that I no longer care about Jody, our supposed hero, and that I actually sympathize with the so-called villain, is a failure of the game design.
Ghost Riders!
Blatant ripoff of Aliens. Blatant ripoff of Metroid. You know, I should probably dismiss everything at this point, but Ryan, in the clothes that he's in, would not only have been crushed by the water pressure at the depth that they were at, but he also wouldn't have made it to the top because of these ice-cold temperatures. Oh look, here comes the plot vehicle.
We have discovered a new world. A world for us to conquer. This is the beginning of a new era for our nation.
So is Ryan Big Boss now? Oh no, he's discount Nick Fury.
I know it's been complicated between us, and I didn't always do the right thing. But maybe we could start again. You know, try and build something together.
Hey, remember that time when we were on the verge of death and I told you that I didn't love you?
No, I don't.
And now you think we can still have a relationship?
When my wife and daughter disappeared in that accident 15 years ago.
Disappeared? You made it clear earlier that they died in a car crash by a drunk driver.
Drunk driver? Wrong side of the road?
Reject and refuse mean the same thing. Game manages to pull a Mass Effect 3 by having your choices not matter. You're still gonna end up helping Nathan either way. The good guy turns into bad guy because he didn't get what he wants cliche.
We can't let you go.
Hey, surprise! You're the villain! But we already knew that. And we don't care.
We inject you with a neural acid.
There's no such thing as neural acid.
I'm going to accomplish man's oldest dream. Nobody will have to die anymore. No one will ever be separated again.
Nathan fails to understand basic physiology. Once the physical body ceases to draw breath and function, they're dead. And there's no way of preventing that. You know, you guys are idiots by acting like you don't know what this is. The utter stupidity of this guard.
I'm sorry, Mr. Freeman. You do not have the correct authorization for this level. I'm sorry, you are on the list.
The self-destruct system has been activated. All personnel evacuate immediately.
You gotta get rid of these goddamn monsters now!
I ought to kill you, McGrath. But the last thing the Infoworld needs is a son of a bitch like you.
Yeah, so let's just keep him alive because the living world needs a son of a bitch like him. As if we don't have enough people like him already. Aw, will you look at that. Three convenient portable containment field devices. Just when you thought the game couldn't get any dumber, this ghost demon that can see and hear through anything is unable to detect Jody hiding behind this tiny crate.
Who are they?
I miss them. Souls! Lost souls!
Are they Dark Souls too? Maybe even Demon Souls? We made it through the entire game and the only person the Green Goblin killed was himself. Also, if you missed your family that much, then why didn't you just do this 15 years ago? I mean, why did you even bother staying alive so that you can build another condenser so you can communicate with them? Would have been much easier if you just off yourself and be done with it. Oh, there goes the script again!
You're the only one who can fix this, Jody. Do it. Do it for me.
Yeah, Jody, do it for me, even though I've lied to you on multiple occasions, kept you as a lab rat, and pretty much left you to clean up my mess so that you can deal with the forthcoming apocalypse. Where the f*** did you come from? You're not dead yet? Why are these ghost demons only attacking Jody and not Ryan? Why did they stop attacking altogether just so we can have this scene? David Cage manages to rip off not only one of the greatest scenes from Metal Gear Solid 4, but one of the greatest scenes in video game history. That alone is worth 100 sins.
My brother.
Revelation that the entity protecting Jody all this time was her stillborn brother, not surprising to anyone. It's a cop-out. Remember, kids, if you're a man and dating a woman, you have the power to end the relationship. Or start the relationship, whenever you choose, because you're a man. And the woman must submit to your dick. But if you're a woman, under no circumstances are you allowed to end the relationship with a man. For he has not released you from his service, and must therefore sleep with him, even though you do not want to. This is all according to David Cage. The utter audacity of David Cage insulting the player by setting this up for a shitty sequel, regardless of your decisions, is worth 80 sins on its own. Plus, it's basically a ripoff of Terminator. David Cage, which, given his track record and the size of his unjustifiably large ego, is worth about 100 sins. Just in case you needed proof that David Cage is a shitty, egotistical human being, well, there you go.
Go fuck yourself.
By God, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you all the most hype gameplay on the internet! Oh, never mind.
Choose your destiny.
Just one question. What if you miss?
I won't.
Kneel before my psycho power!
I just died on your arms tonight.
Here is a church and here is a steeple. Sure, I'd kill for two ugly people. Don't see what anyone can see in anyone else. But
what I did. What are you trying to show me?
Inception.